Hi, I am Lois Melarano. I am a licensed wildlife rehabilitator for the state of Connecticut. And this little guy that I'm holding here is a juvenile mink. I would guess probably around 3 months old or so. You can really see the difference between them and the weasels. He's a little chunkier, a little more solid. He's got a shorter, fatter tail. He's much darker. And he has the defining white chin patch. That's how we know for sure he's a mink. He's got a little white on him elsewhere too. These guys were unfortunately left in a bag behind the museum last Saturday. I would love to get their history. Don't know if they were raised by a rehabber, if they were prepared for their life in the wild or not, so I will hang on to them for about a week. I've already checked to see that they can catch fish, but of course they eat more than that. They eat fish, they eat frogs, they eat shellfish, they eat mice, rats. They really have a varied diet, but we want to make sure that they're nice and plump and ready to go when they're released. I have three of them, none of whom are very cooperative. Mink, as beautiful as they are, can be very, very nasty. And that's why I'm using. And they can also be very vocal. There, you can get a little bit of a better look at him there before he decides he wants to bite me. They've got really neat little feet, and they also hiss. These guys haven't eaten yet today, so we're going to put a mouse in there. It'll be a dead mouse. And we will see what they do with it if I can get them all in one spot. I'm going to start with one mouse and see what they do. That's not the mouse, that's the mink. And what he's doing is he's hiding from his siblings because they will try to take it away from him. Now this one over here I think has the inkling that somebody's eating and he's not. And he's going to try and hide with it. Okay, now the other one's got some interest. And they can really be quite vicious with each other when it comes to food competition. Now, this guy is just going to hide. He's not even eating it. He's just trying to keep it from everybody else. You can see they're very competitive. And now here comes the third one to get in the battle. These are our three little mink friends. I've had them for 6 days now. They're doing very well. They're capturing their own food. So it is time to say goodbye. We are on the back side of Ongley Pond where there's lots of brush for cover, this nice old rotted tree, and of course the pond right there. They will be very happy here, but they won't be happy when I'm taking them out. There's one little guy already on his way. Here's the second little guy already on his way. This is the stubborn one.
He's gonna yell.
This is the third one. This is the biggest male. And I can hear one of them in the bush calling. They're all heading in the same spot, so they'll hang out together for a little while. And here comes number 3.